Okay, the next item of business is a member's business debate on motion 4821 in the name of Miles Briggs on Cancer Card. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I'd invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons now or as soon as possible. And I call on Miles Briggs to open the debate for around 7 minutes. Mr. Briggs.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. And can I start by thanking members for supporting my motion for debate today? I'd also like to invite and highlight to members the photo call at the bottom of the Garden Lobby steps at 1:35 following the debate, and I hope members will be able to join us. Deputy Presiding Officer, one of the greatest honours about being an MSP is the opportunity that it presents to meet remarkable people. I think all of us would agree on that. One such person is Jen Hardy. And I'm delighted Jen has joined us today in the public gallery alongside Ian Peary, the new CEO of Cancer Card. I first met Jen back in March 2018 when she successfully campaigned alongside women with incurable breast cancer and the charity Breast Cancer Now to help deliver access to the secondary breast cancer drug at Perjeta. And I'm pleased that the Cabinet Secretary said these discussions continue and the work of Breast Cancer Now in campaigning is also something which yesterday he was part of. Jen was diagnosed with stage 4 incurable breast cancer on the 18th of October 2017 after having a CT scan to find out the cause of her paralysed vocal cord. While searching for cancer support, Jen noticed there was no single place or online resource that listed the hundreds of different support services, support providers, information channels, and free experiences available to people and their families living with cancer. It was this realisation that prompted Jen, who has an IT background, to work to establish Cancer Card, to help create that single place, single online point of access for anyone affected by cancer to find the help and support that they need. Cancer Card launched in May of this year and provides a detailed index of support services available, helping individuals navigate what can often be a complicated and complex world of cancer. Deputy Presiding Officer, it's hard ahead of this debate to believe that Cancer Card didn't actually exist until now. And I know that it's incredibly hard to have the difficult conversations with someone living with cancer about their treatment journey. And indeed, the many and often personal questions a wife, husband, mother, father, sister, brother, daughter, or son or friend simply want to ask. That is where Cancer Card is so wonderful. It recognises the questions and support needed to reach more than just the person living with cancer, but indeed their partners, families and friends, employers and professionals as well. And it's available any time of day and night when questions will be asked or answers and support is sought. It also acts as a directory for key contacts for all UK cancer charities and support services. Deputy Presiding Officer, one in two of us will develop cancer in our lifetimes. In my time over the last 6 years as the co-chair of the Parliament's cross-party group on cancer alongside Jackie Bailey, it's been a regular ask of many clinicians, of many charities and groups to improve access, to make the support services more readily available. And that is what Cancer Card offers. The significance of a cancer diagnosis on an individual's life is immense, with the potential to render them feeling lost, frustrated, fatigued, isolated, or financially disadvantaged when trying to obtain information of a non-medical but nonetheless essential nature. At a time when people living with cancer and their families need the most support, it can often be difficult to find the right information at the right time for the right person. Cancer Card seeks to address this through the online support hub where those affected by cancer find invaluable insights from the Cancer Card community and access to local and national cancer support charities and services, including financial help, exercise classes, counselling and local support networks as well. The advanced search and filtering options also allow users to create a bespoke search based on their individual needs. I think that's very important. For those who have not had the opportunity to see for yourselves, I'd ask you to please visit cancercard.org.uk. Deputy Presiding Officer, I also want to take this opportunity to pay tribute and thanks to all those charities and organisations which provide information, help and advice to people and families living with cancer. We owe these organisations a huge debt of gratitude, and the difference they are making to people's lives and those living with cancer is so significant across our country right now. I believe Cancer Card can and will indeed elevate cancer support charities and services and help promote their invaluable offering. There is no cost to users or charities for the services listed, and indeed for local groups. I think this is going to present a great opportunity to highlight what is available in different localities across Scotland. Deputy Presiding Officer, to close, the Scottish Government is currently undertaking work on the new cancer strategy, and I welcome that. I believe this does now present an opportunity to reset and reconsider how support and advice is provided in Scotland and across the UK, and how, especially during and following the pandemic, how access has shifted online. I hope the new strategy can embrace Cancer Card, and this fresh and new approach can indeed provide the information advice services people living with cancer and their families and friends so desperately need and want to access. Thank you to members for allowing this debate to take place, and look forward to hearing contributions this afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Briggs. We now move to the open debate. I call first Kenneth Gibson, to be followed by Jackie Bailey for around 4 minutes. Mr. Gibson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I congratulate Miles Briggs for securing this afternoon's debating time. We all know that cancer is one of the major causes of disease and death in Scotland, with more than 30,000 patients diagnosed and over 16,000 people dying from cancer recorded every year. Indeed, sadly, half of us will be diagnosed with cancer at some stage throughout our lives. Unfortunately, the unprecedented challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic have also had a significant impact on cancer treatment, ranging from temporary pauses in screening programmes to longer waits for CT scans and colonoscopies, threatening the steady progress made in cutting cancer mortality rates in recent years. New research published in The Lancet Oncology on Monday showed that countries with cancer policies that are consistent over time are more successful in improving survival across a range of cancer types. Scotland has fared better than other UK nations, but still lags behind countries like Denmark, which is amongst the highest increase in survival rates after maintaining a cross-party consensus on policy and the level of investment required. That being said, I welcome the establishment of Cancer Card in Scotland and congratulate Jen Hardy on her tireless work in setting up this online hub after being diagnosed with stage 4 incurable metastatic breast cancer in October 2017. Throughout her lived experience and by navigating the information support available, Jen found there was no all-encompassing hub to bring together the numerous cancer charities and support services that are out there. That gap is what Cancer Card seeks to fill and does fill. What I found particularly interesting while browsing the new Cancer Card website is how easy it is now to find the tailored support right for each individual, as Miles Briggs highlighted. Depending on the type of cancer one or a loved one has, their location and relationship with cancer. Being diagnosed with cancer is understandably a huge shock to most people, and easy access to the right resource will make an already highly stressful and worrying time a little less difficult. Videos and blogs from people who have survived cancer before can also help to provide some reassurance. In 2010, my twin sister had breast cancer so virulent she was operated on within 72 hours of her initial diagnosis. Janice had radiotherapy, chemo, and has now been cancer-free for more than 11 years. So the big C, as John Wayne used to famously call it, need not be a terminal diagnosis if caught early and or treated aggressively. I also welcome Cancer Card's vision of supporting everyone affected by cancer, with help being directed not only to the patient, but their partner, family members, friends, and indeed employers too. Hope this new directory will be of assistance to my constituents by signposting them to the numerous amazing local charities and support services available across Ayrshire and Arran. This includes Ayrshire's leading cancer charity, Ayrshire Cancer Support, which provides practical help and emotional support to people affected by cancer, including transport and complementary therapies. And the same applies to Arran Cancer Support Trust, which supports cancer patients and their families with the very unique challenges that island life can pose. Not only do they offer counselling and wellbeing support, but volunteers also pick up Arran acts at Drossan Harbour, take them to a mainland hospital, wait or come back to take them on the return ferry to Arran, where transport can also be arranged to and from the ferry terminal. I'd like to thank everyone involved in local charities for the efforts, and indeed everyone in the third sector, a vitally important partner for the NHS in our efforts to combat cancer. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, I've no doubt that Cancer Card will play a vital role in improving patients as well as family members and friends' access to the many vital resources that are out there, signposting them to the local charity or support service best suited to their needs. And I will certainly do my bit to make my constituents aware of the help that Cancer Card can offer. I'd once again like to congratulate Jen Hardy on setting up Cancer Card and Miles Briggs on bringing this important topic to the Chamber.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gibson. And I call Jackie Bailey, to be followed by Graeme Simpson, for around 4 minutes, Ms. Bailey.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I would like to begin by also congratulating Miles Briggs on securing this Members' Debate to celebrate the work of Cancer Card. With one in two people diagnosed with cancer during our lifetime, there are not many of us that can say we've not been touched by cancer. Whether it's a personal story or that of family and friends, the experience is real and it's often very difficult. A cancer diagnosis comes with a whirlwind of emotion. There's an overwhelming amount of information to take in at once, accompanied by worries about loved ones and concerns around finances, especially now during the cost of living crisis. And of course, it has an impact on work, as many have to give up employment for a period of time. And despite the support that is available, the landscape is new, is very difficult to navigate for those who have just had a diagnosis. And that's where Cancer Card comes in, an online hub bringing together all the information you need. So can I join with others in congratulating Jen Hardy, Ian Perry and the team, because they've managed the quite remarkable task of pulling all that information together so you can find out all you need to know about receiving support once you've received your diagnosis. This helping hand is going to be invaluable in making people feel less alone at such a hard time, and we're all aware of the pressures being faced by our health service, and the work of Cancer Card is needed now more than ever. Figures for the quarter ending 30th June 2022 showed performance against the 62-day cancer waiting times target were at their lowest point since records began, with just 76% of patients starting treatment within that target time. It's a target that regretfully has never been met, so we need to do more collectively to deal with that. But we're also seeing the toll that lockdown has taken on early diagnosis of cancer, with more people presenting with late-stage cancers than before, and it's against that backdrop that Cancer Card's work truly shines. They are a light in the dark, offering advice and lived experience, as well as helping people and their families to navigate this new world, and a support for staff that are also stretched to the limit. And they're not alone in carrying out this vital work. I want to recognise organisations like Macmillan Cancer Support, there to assist people when their lives have been turned upside down in whatever way necessary, whether they're having issues with finances or struggling with their mental health. Marie Curie, helping to provide overnight palliative care for cancer patients at home, as well as in their valuable hospice provision. Their nurses care for people in 31 out of 32 local authority areas in Scotland, and their work ensures that vital research in palliative and end-of-life care continues to be a priority. And of course, cancer research do similarly important work together with clinicians looking at improving treatments for the future, funding scientists, doctors and nurses to help beat cancer sooner. It is the work of these charities and many more that make an immeasurable difference to the lives of people across the country. They do it because they care, and because many of them have experienced the effects of a cancer diagnosis firsthand. So we must continue to support charities like Cancer Card, and because from 2015 to 2019, something like 141,000 adults in Scotland received a cancer diagnosis, and those numbers show no sign of decreasing anytime soon. Presiding Officer, the fight against cancer continues, but thanks to the work of Cancer Card and other charities, these battles are not fought alone, and for this, we thank them.
Thank you very much indeed, Ms Bailey. I now call Graeme Simpson. Again, around 4 minutes, Mr Simpson.
Thank you very much, and can I also congratulate Miles Briggs for securing this debate. And I wanted to speak because most of us will have been affected by cancer in some way, either ourselves or of our families or people that are close to us. And I'm no exception, but I'm not going to regale any personal story today. It's just to say that we'll all know about cancer and we know the effects it can have. So I had a look at, obviously, the website. What wasn't clear to me that was that there was a card involved anywhere, but Deputy Presiding Officer, there is a card. Miles Briggs handed me the card earlier, and I think the idea is that when somebody is diagnosed with cancer anywhere in Scotland, they'll be given this card. and on the back there's a barcode, so you can scan that and that will take you to the website. And I've tried it and it works. And then when you get to the website, of course, as you've heard already, that is basically a one-stop shop of services across Scotland. So I think it's a fantastic resource it can be built on, because obviously when you get a diagnosis of cancer, there is that feeling of despair and what do I do now? And, you know, you really need to know where to turn. The website, I think, is really good because it's localised. There are services throughout Scotland. In my own patch, in Lanarkshire, we've got listed places like Kilbride Hospice, Lanarkshire Cancer Care Trust, Lanarkshire Carers, the Lanarkshire Speakeasy Group, that's for people who've got throat cancer, Maggie's Lanarkshire and Leukaemia Care, Move More North Lanarkshire, Strathcarron Hospice, and of course there'll be more groups out there. So I think this is really good, and I congratulate Jen Hardy for getting it set up. I think we can build on it. It needs to be promoted. What we actually need, and I don't know whether this is in place yet, is just that situation I described at the start of when somebody is diagnosed, everybody should be given this so that they're signposted to those local and national services. And I think that would be a great comfort and help to people. So once again, congratulations to Miles Briggs and to Jen Hardy for getting this going. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Mr. Simpson. I now invite Hamza Yousaf to respond to the debate. Cabinet Secretary, around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you very much, Deputy Presiding Officer. Can I congratulate and thank Miles Briggs for securing debating time this afternoon on what is a really important subject, and one that's clearly going by the contributions and unsurprisingly close to everybody's heart for many personal reasons. But even then, if you have not had a personal experience of cancer or somebody close to you, even hearing the stories of those that have been, I know we have all been moved often to tears hearing some of the challenges those who have had a cancer diagnosis over the years have had to face. Can I also offer my full support to everything that has been said by every single contributor this afternoon, and can I join each and every one of them and paying tribute to Jen Hardy, who's in our gallery today, alongside Ian Pirrie as well, the first CEO of Cancer Card. Miles Briggs was right. There are tough times in the job, for sure, but one of the best parts of the job, I think, for all of us as members of the Scottish Parliament, is the people we get to meet and the phenomenal stories that we hear along the way. And there are people... I enjoy meeting everybody, of course, that I do end up meeting, but there are certain people that have an energy about them, and they immediately light up the room, and that energy stays with you, I think, for quite a while. I can think of a number of people I've met over the years like that, and Jen Hardy is absolutely one of those people. I only met her yesterday, but I could feel from her the enthusiasm for what she was doing, the energy from her in terms of wanting to improve the lives and give support to others that have had a cancer diagnosis. And thankfully, I've never had a personal diagnosis. I've known many people close to me that have, but nobody would fault Jen for just dealing with life and getting on with life in her own way, and just dealing with the difficulties that a diagnosis such as hers throws up. You know, she undoubtedly is getting on with life, but what she is doing is trying to, and doing this very well, supporting others through the efforts of Cancer Card. And for that, I pay her all the tribute in the world that I possibly can for the fact that she is using her time to make sure that other people right across the country have support. I wanted to pick out a couple of points that were raised by colleagues during this debate. You know, the best ideas, and again, I've seen this in my time as an MSP, in my time as government, the best ideas are always those that are the most simple. I think all of us can think of examples of that. Mary's Meals is a great example. You know, a simple idea, a simple concept, so effective. Cancer Card is in the same bracket. It's a simple idea, a one-stop shop of information that people can access. If you haven't been to the Cancer Card website, please do go on it. You put in your location, you put in some basic information about what cancer type you're suffering from or would like support in relation to, and a click later, you get a web page giving you access, contact details to those support groups that are closest to you. Simple idea, really, really effective. And what I hear from a number of third sector cancer support organisations, charities, is that people don't hear about that support until well down the line in terms of their journey, their cancer journey. An example of this was when I recently visited the Maggie Centre, Edinburgh. I think it'll be known by many, probably visited by a number of people across the chamber, and they told me, you know, they wouldn't need to do any fundraising if they had a pound for every time that somebody walked through the door and said, "Oh, I wish I'd known about you guys sooner and earlier." And we don't want that to be the case. We want people to have information on diagnosis, that support, as Graeme Simpson was rightly saying, you know, given that information so they can access that support right away. We do have to think about the point that Jackie Bailey made, and I think she made it well, that we've heard from people who've had a diagnosis that when they get that information, you know, many of them will go almost into a state of shock. They won't necessarily absorb all the information that they are receiving. So really important that we follow up and the NHS follows up with those individuals and make sure that we are giving them the information about the support, not just once, not by just giving the card once, although I think that's an excellent idea, and I'll take that one away and I'll address some of the points in that regard shortly. We should be making sure we are going back and going back and going back to make sure those individuals get the support that they required. Miles Briggs asked a very reasonable question around the new cancer strategy. I think this debate is taking place at a really opportune time because we are very much in the development phase of that new cancer strategy. I'm certain many organisations and individuals, well, I know many organisations and individuals have inputted to the consultation of that strategy. But I can give them an absolute commitment that how support is accessed is going to be a key part of that strategy. And absolutely, we will be looking, having met with Jen yesterday and also met with Breast Cancer Now yesterday, that we will absolutely consider how Cancer Card can be part of that support that is offered. And how do we ensure that our clinical colleagues know about Cancer Card as well? So all good and well, us knowing about it, maybe it having public knowledge, really important our clinicians know about it too, because they're often the ones that are giving that really difficult news to somebody about a cancer diagnosis. I also agree with the points that I made about third sector support being more important than ever before. I think that was the case even pre-pandemic, but certainly since the challenges the pandemic has brought to bear, that is exceptionally important. I agree with the points made about early diagnosis too, and how important that can be, and that's why we're investing in our rapid cancer diagnostic services. In fact, the First Minister announcing two additional rapid cancer diagnostic services so that people can get that earlier diagnosis sooner, given that we know through really difficult decisions that we had to make during the pandemic that we have this backlog of diagnostics when it comes to cancer. So can I really end, Presiding Officer, Deputy Presiding Officer, by finishing where I started, and that is to commend Jen Hardy for the work that she has done in relation to Cancer Card. What has been achieved so far, as I say, a really easy to use website. Graeme Simpson, it is a QR code on the back of the card as opposed to a barcode, but we will bring Graeme Simpson into the 21st century kicking or screaming. But if they just scan that QR code, of course, they get immediate access to that website. And it doesn't just focus on the patients. If you've seen the website, it also gives support and access to support, I should say, for partners, for families, employers as well, all who have different support needs and information needs as well. So this resource is a fantastic addition to the support that we already provide. As I said, I've given a commitment here to see how we can incorporate that in the future work we do in terms of our strategy. But can I again thank Miles Briggs for securing this time, but can I once again congratulate Jen and the team at Cancer Card for all the incredible work that they have done. I wish her every best of health in the future. I wish the Cancer Card charity every success in the future, and their help, their work will help a great many people in the future. I'm certain of that.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. A whole new exciting world of QR codes has just opened up for Mr. Simpson, but that concludes the debate, and I suspend this meeting of Parliament until 2:30.